Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Sunday or Monday, depending on your time zone, SpaceX successfully launched the Starlink 6-5 mission.
1, ignition, and liftoff, go Starlink, open up.
The booster which launched this mission, B1058, broke a record and landed successfully for the 16th time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions.
Stage 1 landing burn.
There's confirmation that the stage 1 landing burn has started in preparation for touchdown on our drone ship, which you see there on the right hand side of your screen.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy. Stage 1 landing confirmed.
And as you can see on your screen, the Falcon 9 first stage has now successfully launched and landed for a record-breaking 16th time.
We can also hopefully expect to see another Starlink mission launch this week. The Starlink 515 mission is currently scheduled for Friday 14th at 4:40 a.m. UTC or 12:40 a.m. EDT. NASA's Launch Services Program posted a tweet about the Psyche satellite. It says, new Psyche image just dropped. Final assembly, test and launch operations has begun. Once the solar arrays and images are installed, a final suite of tests will be run and mission to Psyche will be fueled and mated onto a SpaceX Falcon Heavy. Launch is targeted for October 2023. Jonathan McDowell posted a tweet with information related to Starlink V2 mini satellites. It says the first group of V2 mini Starlinks launched on February 27th ran into trouble right away, but three of them had raised their orbits to 480 kilometers by late April. However, those three are now lowering their orbits again, likely for early retirement. Heading to Boca Chica, here's a view of the launch site. A water deluge manifold was seen being installed under the orbital launch mount. In the production yard, there was another new high bay section seen moved. This new section was also seen lifted and installed. Here's a look at the new Star Factory expansion and how it's progressing. SpaceX has plans to upgrade Starship at some point to use 6 vacuum engines rather than 3. Zach Golden posted a picture of how this engine layout could look and said, "Can't wait for this." Musk responded and said, "Inner engine gimbal angle is limited in some directions due to impacting outer engine nozzle, but probably okay." Elon Musk posted a couple of tweets with other information related to Starship. The first says, looks like we can increase Raptor thrust by approximately 20% to reach 9,000 tons or 20 million pounds of force at sea level. Then he also posted saying, and deliver over 200 tons of payload to a useful orbit with full and rapid reusability. 50 rockets flying every 3 days on average enables over a megaton of payload to orbit per year, enough to build a self-sustaining city on Mars. This S24.2 test tank was spotted moved out of the high bay and into the yard. Elon Musk posted this really cool picture I wanted to share of the engine section of Starship 25 as it sits on the test mount. The crane was seen hooked up to Starship 25. Last week, SpaceX rolled the Booster 10 prototype to Massey's test site for possible cryo testing. As always, I have to say thanks to both Nick Answeeney and Jack Beyer for being out there filming the Boca Chica content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.